Hello, this is the Provoked Prawn, and in this video I'm talking to you about how to improve the sound of your HyperX Quadcast or Quadcast S. I'm going to be showing you various different things that you can do to improve the sound capture quality of your Quadcast to make it sound a lot richer. And I'm using the microphone now to do the voiceover for this video with some of the tweaks, so I'm going to show you what to do. The first and most important thing to do, if you can do this, is to get it off its mic stand and onto a boom arm. Taking it off the mic stand removes it away from any noises that might include keyboard and mouse clicks and other sounds on your desk that could otherwise negatively impact the sound quality. Also, getting it on a boom arm means that you can move it closer to your mouth, which then means that you can turn the gain down, which makes a drastic difference to the amount of background noise that it picks up and also improves the overall quality. You can see it here with the Blue Compass boom arm, which I've done a video on separately on how to tighten it and make sure it works with your Quadcast S, so check that out on the link in the description. But now I want to talk to you about the various other things that you need to do. So obviously getting it on a boom arm is the first step of it, but you need to make sure it's close to your mouth and facing the right direction. And that's a really important point, because this microphone is able to capture from multiple different directions, but in an ideal world you want to be talking into the front. That's where the logo is, so roughly here where that RGB is. Obviously this has the bonus that you also get to see the RGB a lot more and show it off on stream if you're into that. And obviously on the S, this is one of the nicest things about it. It's very fancy looking, it's very swish, and it will give you a nice calming glow on your face. Now, one of the other things to do is to make sure that it's in cardioid mode. So you have a polar pattern selector on the rear, and you want to select cardioid, which looks like a bottom or an upside down heart. And that is seen here. What that does is it makes sure that it picks up the sound from the front of the microphone and minimizes any other sound from the surrounding areas. Next thing to do is to go to the Microsoft Store on your Windows PC and download HyperX's Ingenuity software. This is a free bit of software that you can get from the store, and basically click and download that and install it and then launch it. And the reason to do this is to check for firmware updates. So open that software up, click on the settings in the bottom left, and check to make sure that you have the latest firmware. If you don't, you should see a prompt that will let you know that you need to download an update. Make sure you do that, because it will improve the quality and make sure that everything's running as it should be. You can also go into the microphone sound settings from here and adjust things like the mic volume and mic monitoring. So if you're plugging a 3.5mm headset into this mic, which you really should be because it will help you with monitoring the sound, then you can adjust the volume here and get an idea of what the mic sounds like for some of the other steps that I'm about to do. Next thing to do is to go into the sound settings by right-clicking the speaker in the bottom right of Windows, and then click down here to more sound settings. This is in Windows 11. Then go onto the recordings tab and find the Quadcast or Quadcast S. You can see it here. Go into the properties tab and then click through into advanced. When you're in advanced, make sure you select the default format for the sample rate and bit depth of 16-bit 48,000 hertz. This will ensure that you have really good capture quality. Also, right click and click set as a default device. This will ensure that the microphone is the only thing and the main thing that's used for your microphone capture, and to ensure that the audio is coming through there. And you can see it's selected as the input device here, so you need to make sure all those things are ticked. Once all that's done, the next step is to adjust the gain. So as I said already, getting the gain down will ensure that you have a better capture quality, because it reduces the amount of background noise that's being picked up. You don't want your sound being ruined by fans on your PC, cars passing by, birds tweeting, wind blowing, or whatever else. This is done by simply rolling the wheel at the bottom, and you can see which way you need to roll it. Essentially, the bigger the dots, the louder the gain. So you need to roll it towards the small dots and make sure that it's in that position. An easy way to do this is to use Obs Studio or Streamlabs Obs. You can see from the mic monitoring at the bottom where that green bar's lighting up, that shows you just how much the microphone's picking up when you're not talking. So if you're quiet in your room and just roll that gain slider, you'll see just how much it's picking up as each adjustment is made. So you can see now that it's barely any sound going through to the microphone at this point. So I have it at a good level where it's not going to be picking up any of that excessive background noise and instead will sound good when I'm using it. Next step is to go into the OBS settings. If you're planning on using OBS, make sure that the mic audio is selected as the Quadcast S. I'm assuming here that you're going to be using it for streaming purposes. Also make sure that your sample rate is set to 48 kilohertz under that audio. That makes the most of the mic's capabilities. Head over to the output tab and go to audio and find the audio bitrate dropdown. Select a higher audio bitrate than the standard one, and that will ensure, again, that you have a better quality of sound out of your recordings and streamings as well. You will notice that there are audio tracks for streaming and recording. This is a bit more detailed view. There are other videos from a lot more intelligent people than me on all the different things you can do with that. Another thing you can do is apply filters. So if you go down to the bottom of OBS and click on the little cog icon next to your mic, you then get the option to apply filters. And you can see that there's a noise suppression filter here. So you have two different options in here. It's worth trying out both to see which one works best for you and your environment. One at a time, obviously. But when you turn those on, you'll notice, again, that the mic volume has dropped right down on the mixer at the bottom. So you can see immediately that's done a good job of blocking out that noise. Using one of these means that you can turn the gain up a little bit if you need to. If you found that the gain's too low in the original demonstration I made. It does, however, take away some of the quality, so it's preferable to reduce the gain if possible. Another thing that you can do is to use Nvidia's Broadcast. So if you have an Nvidia graphics card, head over to Google and search for Nvidia Broadcast. Download this free software and run through the steps for installing it. Nvidia Broadcast essentially uses AI to reduce the background noise, and it's really intelligent software that means that you can minimize the amount of background noise. Once that's installed, it will launch, and you basically just need to select your microphone from the software. So there's a few different steps here. Essentially, we go into the microphone tab and we find the Quadcast or Quadcast S again. You can see it listed as one of the microphones here. You can also see the effect of noise removal and the strength that's being applied, and you can test it in there. Now go back into the Windows sound settings and you need to change things a little bit, because instead of having the mic set to the Quadcast in Windows sound settings, we now just need to set it to Nvidia Broadcast. So what you're doing is you're basically sending your mic through the Nvidia Broadcast software and then telling Windows that's the main one that you're going to be using for the sound settings. You also need to select a speaker setup, so we're going to choose Astro 50 because that's the headset I'm using. Make sure that's selected in Windows sound settings and in Nvidia Broadcast. This ensures the sound comes through your headset correctly, as it should do when you're playing games and doing other things like streaming. So this little bit of software obviously will put a bit of extra pressure on your graphics card, and it doesn't work with all GPUs, so you need an Nvidia one, and the more recent the better, but it does help to reduce a lot of the background noise and minimize the problems that you might have. So if you found that turning the gain down isn't working for you and the other things I've suggested, this is another option. You also have the option to use this through OBS as well, so it will eliminate some of that noise, and it means that you can improve the quality of your stream and the sound of your voice when you're doing it. So different steps. Go back into the sound settings, find the mic drop down and select microphone Nvidia Broadcast instead of the Quadcast, and that will then mean that it was then passing through, and you can check to see whether that's showing up and how much background noise is being picked up. And you can see when it's running through Broadcast that it isn't actually picking up any background noise, and you can turn the gain up in this way, so then you have a better setup there. So there's quite a few different steps. Now I want to show you what I would do if I'm recording voiceovers. So if you're not doing a live recording and you want to do a voiceover instead, I like to use Audacity, and I'll show you why in a second. But what we need to do is basically select the microphone from the drop down. Also make sure that your project sample rate is at 48,000 hertz, so that matches the microphone quality and ensures that you've got the best quality there. Now, without talking any sound, just press record and you'll then start to talk a bit later on. The reason for this I'll show you in a second, but essentially you want to see how things work in there. Now select all, control A, and then select to normalize from the effects tab. You'll then see that all the levels have been pushed up, including this area at the beginning where I wasn't talking. This is background noise, and it's a horrid noise that you want to get rid of. So select that part and select noise reduction, get noise profile, then control I to select everything again, and then apply this noise reduction. You can see that then wipes out that background noise from the recording and ensures that you have good sound there. You can then go in and export, and I'd recommend exporting it as a WAV file because that allows you to have a better quality. And I use the 32-bit PCM signed as well. So you can then export your file there. This is obviously a different use case, but if you're doing voiceovers for YouTube videos or other things and you aren't doing live capture, then this is a good way to reduce background noise and also to make sure the mic sounds great for those as well. So hopefully you found this video useful. Smash that subscribe button to say thanks. Let me know in the comments if you've got any questions. Check out the description for more information, links that you might find useful. This has been the Provoked Prawn. Thanks for watching. This has been the Provoked Prawn. Hope you found this video useful, interesting, hilarious, or otherwise. Take a look at these other videos that I think you might find interesting as well. And have a look at the description for links and other information you might find useful. Click that join button to see the benefits of being a member of my YouTube channel. And most importantly, have a great life.